It's possible.
Get out of here.
Why? Most women at one time or another have faked it.
Well, they haven't faked it with me.
Oh, right. I forgot. You're a man.
You don't think that I could tell the difference? Hey, you okay?
Yes. Right there. Yes.
Oh, well, she's having.
Yeah, we're all going to hell.
Fuck me. Please.
I'm bad. I'm gonna be late for my flight.
I don't care. I can't not see you for 3 months.
Don't be a baby.
I love you.
Careful. You may just marry you and ruin your life.
You better. Fine. Go be with your dead people, doctor.
Figuring out how they die is gonna help people.
Your hands are so cold.
Time's gonna feel like nothing, okay?
I missed you already.
Love you.
I love you.
Gray?
Ben Stravinsky.
I am Ben Stravinsky.
I take it you'll be showing me around.
Ted Gray, I am all over it. Here we are. County Morgue. The real banana. Hey, you check out from any unnatural or unexplained cause within the city limits, well, you end up here. As residents, we get full access. All right. This is pathology room number 1. It's been pretty slow lately, but holiday season's around the corner, should hopefully pick up. Certain people around here couldn't possibly be any more annoying.
Beg your pardon?
Oh no, I was... Some of these guys last year, they decided that they were gonna be God's gift to this place. You have a girlfriend?
As a pathologist, you will learn the nature of disease and its causes, its processes, development, and consequences. But far, far more than that. I like to think that the pathologist has offered a window to God, if you will. Now, it may be said that pathology is a study in all things human, save for the soul, of course. But it is in that particular branch of pathology known as forensics that we will delve into what it means to be inhuman. You will see the perversion and the corruption of the flesh by all means unnatural, by violence, by toxin, by madness. And then we will work backwards, always back to that original pristine design to determine the offending cause of death.
Dr. Morris.
Oh, you are.
Huh. Dr. Stravinsky, I want you to hunt down Jake Gallo. Tell him I want to see him chop-chop.
Yes, sir.
Well, quite a pleasure. I've heard a great deal about you. How's Africa?
Hell of a challenge. Quite humbling, though. We're very privileged here.
Indeed. I spoke to your future father-in-law this morning. He's quite proud of you, you know. And Gwendolyn, have you had a chance to see her since you've been home?
Only briefly.
Oh, that's a pity. I have known that girl since she was barely out of braces. She's become quite a woman. You are indeed privileged and evidently quite talented.
Dr. Morris.
Dr. Gallo. I would like you to meet Dr. Gray.
Hello, Dr. Gray.
Ted comes to his top of his class from Harvard. 18 weeks at Bellevue in New York City.
Oh, patient?
Before being accepted in the UNICEF program in Lagos, where he has been for the past 4 months.
Bleeding heart. I cut one of those in half this morning.
Jake is our young star in residence. Single-handedly solved the Horton family murders. If it weren't for a little student internship, I think the FBI would still be fingering around.
Damn.
I expect you two will get along quite well.
Doctor, this is a simple case of kidney failure.
Blood in the urine, general swelling.
I mean, look at his skin. It's like cheddar cheese.
Excuse me, if I may interject.
By all means.
V-may interject?
Given the boy's medical history, I believe he died during a state of hypoxia, an asthma attack.
Fresh out of the medical books. Oh, forgive me, that seems more like a hypochondrial conclusion than an answer for the deceased.
11-year-old boy, overweight. In his last report, Daniel stated he was being ridiculed at school for his weight. The weight he started gaining when he began taking pediapred to treat an acute asthma condition. You're gonna notice there's no trace of the steroid in blood or bladder.
Blah, 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 blah.
Is there a problem?
Doctor, please, continue.
He stopped taking the steroid. In his mind, the abuse he suffered from his peers for being fat was worse than the asthma itself. Finally, during a field trip to the zoo, he died from a severe attack. One can't disregard psychology in forming a diagnosis.
Ted Gray, home run. No question about it. Acute asthma.
Ooh, no. I think it's coagulated nasal mucus. Death by Booker.
Sorry, man, I didn't see you there. Hey, you wanna know if there was a problem? There's one. We don't like you.
It's not a problem.
Yeah, so I met Dr. Morris today.
I think the guy still has a crush on you.
Or me. Can't be too sure. Yeah. Yeah, I'm still excited. The place is beautiful. The school's beautiful. Everything's beautiful. You're beautiful. Hey, I gotta get up in 4 hours. You're corrupting me. Yeah, I love you too. Bye.
All right, everybody, gather around. I want you to meet my friend Carl.
Hello, Carl.
Hey, Carl.
What did I say, Carl?
Now, several weeks back, his doctors recorded that Carl